Hello. The issue of flickering lights is something I previously touched on during the bench light build 4 years ago, which is still going strong, by the way. Having swapped the remaining fluorescents out of the workshop in favour of the 600mm square panels you usually find in offices, I was occasionally getting a flicker problem. The issue is that it's not all that easy to see whilst actually recording. It's only later when the footage is reviewed that it becomes apparent. Sometimes I can go back and do a take two, but if it's a one-off event, I have to decide whether the material stays or ends up on the cutting room floor. This locked-off shot of a light panel looks fairly static, but the waveform monitor reveals a steady cyclic change in brightness. The problem stems from the power supply for the lights being made to a size and a price and a performance, and consequently, they don't produce very clean DC on their output. There's an AC component superimposed on top. I have two sets of 48-watt panels, a pair I got back in July 2017, and a pair I got in February 21. I'd naively assumed that 48 was 48 and that they were the same, but as part of making this film, I discovered they're actually different. The 2017 ones run at a little under 600 milliamps and 75 volts, whereas the 2021 ones run at a little under 1.2 amps and 37 volts. So both are roughly 43 watts, a bit less than the 48 watts advertised. This difference in supply will be down to the series parallel arrangement of the individual LEDs inside the panels, and it means the drivers aren't interchangeable. The 2017 panels have 8.4 volts of ripple, and the 2021 ones have 3.8 volts, both roughly 10% of the output voltage, with the older panels doing slightly worse. For these tests, I'm actually triggering the scope from the 50Hz mains, and the 100Hz ripple is locked to it, which suggests the driver doesn't have a free-running oscillator inside. I reckon this is just a case of some of the rectified mains making it to the output. UK mains frequency is 50Hz, and the camera is running at 50 progressive frames per second, so you might expect there not to be an issue. Averaged over a period of time, the National Grid's mains frequency is bang on, but second to second, it does wobble around a bit. My consumer camcorder can't be genlocked and just free runs, and no doubt will drift with temperature, so there's plenty of opportunity for phase differences to show themselves. It's not always a problem, especially at normal play speed, but it can become very noticeable when running the footage faster than real time, which is something I do quite often. I should just point out that the panel lights themselves don't have a light and a dark area running over them. The entire panel is actually getting slightly more or less bright over its whole surface. Pulsating, if you like. I reckon the blame for the pattern that I'm seeing is an artefact of the rolling shutter on the camera's CMOS sensor. As lines of pixels are clocked out from the top to the bottom of the sensor, the pulsating light from my panels results in a slightly different brightness being recorded to the SD card from different areas of the frame. Now, the difference between adjacent frames is minimal, but when jumping ahead multiple frames to create faster than real time, the brightness change can become quite objectionable. Temporal aliasing can be a help, it can be a hindrance, or it can be a bit of a head scratcher. However you look at it, it's a bit beyond the scope of this little film, so back to the project. The answer was to add a 4700 mic capacitor to provide additional smoothing. This may or may not be an optimal value, it's just what I had under the bench. As you can see, it reduces the ripple by a factor of 10. Using DC to DC jack extensions and crudely insulated with hot melt glue, the capacitor can simply be fitted in series without having to dismantle either panel or power supply. I was a little bit concerned about strapping what amounts to a short circuit straight across the driver, and dreamt up some soft start options, but the drivers currently limit by design and appear happy to fill the empty capacitor. It just means that the panels take a fraction of a second to come on until the cap's full, and they remain lit for a short time when switched off until the cap is empty. The result on the flicker is plain to see. Not 100% removed, but for a quick and dirty fix it's greatly improved. It even stands up to the 40 times speed and waveform monitor test. If anyone else decides to give this a go, remember, the working voltage of your capacitor must be equal or greater than the maximum output voltage of your driver, not just the forward voltage of your panel. and be sure to observe the polarity, or you'll soon have a foul-smelling explosion to deal with. Beware that, depending on their design, your LED drivers may not be fully isolated from the mains. And finally, remember that there's enough energy stored in a capacitor charged to the thick end of 100 volts to bite the unwary user. If you're in any doubt, leave well alone. And that's about it for this one. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you next time.